We want to solve the given equation by writing it in quadratic form and then solve by factoring. For this equation, we want to write it in the form of 2u squared minus u minus 10 equals 0. So we want to check to see if we square the variable factor of the middle term, or in this case, the square root of x, it would be equal to the variable factor of the first term, in this case, x. So we're going to write this as 2 times the square root of x squared, which is equal to x, minus the square root of x minus 10 equals 0. So we could perform a substitution where u is equal to the square root of x, but if we recognize that this is in quadratic form, there's no need to do that. We can go ahead and factor it in this form. So we'll have two binomial factors, except instead of using 2x and x, we'll use 2 square root x and square root x, and that will place the factors of negative 10 in here, so that the sum of the inner product and outer product will equal negative 1 square root x. Notice if we put plus 2 here and minus 5 here, we'd have negative 5 square root x plus 4 square root x, which is equal to negative 1 square root x. So now this is factored correctly, and this product is equal to 0 when these factors are equal to 0. So now we'll solve the equation 2 square root x minus 5 equals 0, or square root x plus 2 equals 0. So now we'll isolate the square root of x. So here we'll add 5 and divide by 2. So we'd have the square root of x equals 5 halves. And now we'll square both sides of the equation. So here we have x equals, this would be 25 fourths. Here we would subtract 2 on both sides. We'd have the square root of x equals negative 2. We should recognize the square root of x will always be greater than or equal to 0. So this isn't possible. But just in case we didn't recognize that and then we squared both sides, we would have x equals 4. This is the reason why it's very important that when applying this technique, we always check our solutions back into the original equation. So let's go ahead and take the time and do that. Let's first check x equals 25 fourths. So we have 2 times 25 fourths minus the square root of 25 fourths minus 10 equals 0. Well, here we have a factor of 2 that simplifies. This would change to a 1, this changes to a 2. So we have 25 halves minus, this would be 5 halves. And we can write 10 as 20 halves. And here we would have, here we have a common denominator, and 25 minus 5 is 20, minus 20 is 0. So this solution checks. Now let's check x equals 4. When x is 4, we would have 2 times 4 minus the square root of 4 minus 10 equals 0. This would be 8 minus 2 minus 10, but this does not equal 0. So x equals 4 is not a solution to this equation. Therefore, we only have one solution, and that is x equals 25 fourths. So again, this is why it's so important to always check our solutions when applying this technique to non-quadratic equations. Okay, we'll take a look at another example in the next video.